Hey all, this is Shubhankar here from Consap. Welcome back to another episode. So in the previous video, we had understood about various different concepts like open interest, what is options OI, what is futures OI. So talking about this video, we are going to understand about the FNO ban and why exactly an instrument enters in FNO ban. What happens if a particular script enters into FNO ban? So let's try to proceed further and let's first try to understand when exactly a script enters into FNO ban. So a stock with the 95% or above market-wide position limit enters into a ban. Okay. So now what is market-wide position limit? Now let's try to understand it very, very quickly. So now let's say there is a company worth total market capitalization of 2000 crore. Out of which 1000 crore is holded by a promoter and the remaining 1000 crore is open in the public. So the 1000 crore which is open in the public, that is called as free float market capitalization. It is free float market capitalization of worth rupees 1000 crore in this particular example. Now what is market wide position limit? It is simple. 20% of the free float market cap is our market wide position limit. So now in this scenario, free float is 1000 crore. So 20% of 1000 crore becomes 200 crore. That is our market-wide position limit. So now, when will this FNO enter into ban? 95% or above, when it crosses the market-wide position limit of 95% and above, the stock will enter into ban. So in this scenario, 95% of 200 crore, which is the market-wide position limit of this script, which is 190. So whenever futures and options open contracts combined crosses the 95% of market wide position limit in a particular stock, that stock enters into FNO ban. You can go ahead and buy in equity in cash segment, but you can't do anything with the stock which is in FNO ban. So now I hope what is market wide position limit? The idea is clear. It is basically the 20% of the free float market capitalization, and a stock will enter into a ban when it exceeds the 95% or above market wide position limit. Now when exactly a script enter into ban? Is it in the trading hours when, you know, now let's say if we are let's say at 2 p.m. let's assume that right now the time is 2 p.m. and if there is a particular stock wherein it crosses the 95% of market wide position limit, is that particular script will enter into ban the very next moment? No. The ban is announced, the ban list is specially announced by the exchange at end of the day. So now let's say by end of the day, if a particular script's market wide position limit is higher than 95%, so that script will enter into FNO ban. We will be allowed to trade in that on that day, but after announcing its ban, after the market, we can't trade in FNO in that particular script which is in ban from next day onwards. So now let's try to understand it very, very simply. Now let's say we have seen stocks market wide position limit crossing even 100%, right? So now let's say that if there is a stock which is continuously its market-wide position limit, it's keeping on increasing. So it won't be stopping very next moment. As on the end of the day, exchange announced that, okay, this script has exceeded 95% of MWPL and it is in ban, then we won't be allowed to trade in that particular FNO from tomorrow onwards, which is from the next day onwards. So that is how a script enters into FNO ban. So now what happens if a script enters into FNO ban? We can't create a fresh open position in futures or options contract in that stock. Wherein, now let's say if sale enters into a ban list, okay? I am having a conviction that sale might go in the upwards direction from here. But using futures and options contract, I can't create new positions in the stock which is in ban. It is not allowed to trade for a fresh, I would say, we can't create a fresh position in it. Although, if we have already a position in a stock entering or which is in ban, we can square it off, but we can't create a fresh position. Now let's say if I have bought a particular futures contract of a stock which is in ban, I can square off my contract, but I can't initiate a new buy contract over there. As simple as that. Now talking about exit. Now when the stock is going to come out of this trading ban, this trading FNO ban, is it going to be the very next point when the market wide position limit goes from 95 to 94? No. The stock will exit out from the ban list only after the market wide position limit, the MWPL of that particular stock goes below 80%. Only then that stock will take an exit from ban, and then only it can be traded normally in futures and options. It won't be the case wherein the very next point when the MWPL comes from, 95 to 94, that straight away it will exit the ban. No, it will only take an exit from the ban list when MWPL goes below 80%. So now the most important question is, where in Quantsap we are going to get this data? So as simple as that, we need to go ahead and search for ban list. So we will get a tool which is made for ban list and the data of it itself, wherein we'll directly get to see which all are the instruments which are in ban. So all these, the securities in ban, so all these are the stocks are which are in ban right now. You can't go ahead and create a fresh position in them in futures and options. Possible entrants, you'll get to see the stocks wherein the market wide position limit is getting closer to 95%. So Cadillac, Tata Motors, Canara Bank, all these are the FNO stocks which might take entry into ban. For the Idea, PNB, Sale, National M, Granules, all these are the FNO stocks which might take an exit from FNO ban. So you see, all of majority of the scripts, all of them, the market wide position limit is below 95%, right? But still they haven't exited ban. So as I said, the stocks wherein the market wide position limit goes below 80%, only then it will take an exit. Further, you'll get to see the market wide position limit for all of the FNO scripts out here. So I would say that pretty much was it from this video. So if you have liked this particular video, so we do post a similar sort of content regularly on YouTube. So do hit the subscribe button, do hit the bell icon, so whenever we post something, you'll receive a notification. So thank you all. See you all in the next video.